By now you would have heard the name 3DEXPERIENCE in the market or from your software reseller. What is the 3DEXPERIENCE platform? Some of the questions you may have asked yourself could have been, is it just another new CAD tool? Is it a database? Is it a cloud storage tool? Everybody's talking about 3DEXPERIENCE platform on the cloud. Or is it an online marketplace or e-commerce tool? Maybe it's just a fancy model viewer. Perhaps you heard that it was an online project management tool where you can give team members tasks directly related to the CAD content, and the system will notify you when a task is complete or late. Well, there's some truth to be had in all of that, and maybe that's why it's been a bit difficult to explain exactly what the 3DEXPERIENCE platform is. Let's break it down. 3D as in 3D CAD model, since initially the data being shared and worked on was CAD data. In reality, the data is so much more and can be of almost any type. Almost always, though, the data in all its forms is related to a product that is being developed, manufactured, and sold, which typically means that it has a CAD model. Experience, this can have a few meanings, but it's intended to mean the experience of the usage of that product or system being developed. There's also good user experience in using the platform itself too. Platform. Typically, platform is there to raise up or hold something in focus. It has a foundation and is strong and reliable. In this case, the platform puts your product in focus across the enterprise and value chain, so it can include customers and suppliers too, and has a solid foundation in the principles of PLM. A key principle is that the platform is scalable. There are one-man band companies through to companies of tens of thousands of users using it on a daily basis. Another key principle is that the platform is usable in multiple industries in multiple scenarios. So, within the limits of your own creativity and the functionality available to you, the platform can do many things to many people. The core purpose is to democratize the business data on the road to full virtual twin, since the virtual world enhances and extends the real world. How that is achieved, and it must first be understood that there are various degrees of virtual twin, is through a collaborative environment where access to data is controlled and the right functionality is made available to the right users within the business landscape. So the platform definitely uses a database, but it isn't one itself. It's not a CAD tool, but there definitely is CAD functionality, and you can connect your existing CAD tool to it. There's cloud storage for you to use and share data, and in order to democratize data, people need to interact with it, so visualizing it is the first step. So there is a viewer too, and collaboration means working together, so task management is fundamental. The 3DEXPERIENCE platform is a business enterprise platform centered around collaboration built on PLM that provides each user with the functionality required to perform their role in the business. There are two main portions to 3DEXPERIENCE platform: structured collaboration and data management, and unstructured collaboration and data management. Structured incorporates PLM principles and rules used for project management, revision control, change management, design, manufacturing, and simulation, for example, while unstructured incorporates the social tools like Swim and 3D Drive. Access to the platform is through roles. A role is a license. Typically, a role includes at least one application, or app, as we say. The most basic role is 3D Swimmer, which gives access to the platform and its base functionality through 9 apps. Roles are named user-based, since a fundamental tenet of PLM is traceability and auditability. So who did what, when, why, how, and where did they put it? Some roles require only 3D Swimmer as a prerequisite, while others require Collaborative Industry Innovator, since this is the core PLM functionality. Further roles sit on top of that to give the functionality required to the user based on their role in the business. Let's take a quick walkthrough. This is not a full demo, since this is a blog post. It's simply a look and feel.
Going straight into the platform, this is what you typically be greeted with. It's a dashboard. This one's obviously been created by myself, but it's easy enough to create. You click on a new tab and you simply drag and drop the app or widget from the role, so the license that it belongs to. There you can resize and distribute the widgets as you want, or allow the system to do it for you. Let's go back to one that I've previously created. You can maximize the widget so that you can focus on it. This is the visualization tool where I'm able to interact with the CAD model without actually having the CAD license. So I can make some annotations or markups and share that with the rest of the team. I also have my task tool. So this is like a to-do list. It's a task that you give yourself or to others, and obviously others can give to you. It's a drag and drop environment, so you can go from in work to completed or back just simply by dragging and dropping. And you can also set obviously the percent complete a little bit more specifically should you want to do that. Let's have a look at the unstructured collaboration. So this is my community. Here I have a number of different post types, from blog posts through to questions and ideas and wikis and surveys. Just as an example, I'm going to show you how to create a question. Simply click on question, give it a title. And then you must put in a bit of body text. And then you publish your question off. So posts get published. And then, of course, somebody else in the team will see the question and typically add an answer. And as the questioner, I can go in and read the answer and validate. And once I've validated that question, it becomes green. So this is a quick visual cue to see if the question has been answered. We also have some other collaborative tools, for example, Story, which is a presentation type tool, Whiteboard, which is exactly that, and then of course 3D Sketch. 3D Sketch is a way to capture conceptual ideas quickly with the team, or at least to share with the team, without having to go into a CAD model and some other drawing package. That's going to give you a loose file floating around. This is here directly in the system. It's managed in the system, and it's there in that specific community, so in that specific team, to collaborate around. You're going to give it a name, since it's becoming a post, essentially, and publish it out to that community. Right, there it is. Available for all. There are other post types like wikis and ideas. We can show that at another blog at some time. Here I've got my product structure. So this is just another widget on another tab, this time showing me my product structure. And on the right hand is the visualization tool. And as I click on the structure, it highlights in the visualization tool and vice versa. And from here I can do things like replace the component or even open the component directly in, for example, in this case, in SolidWorks. So let's do that. There comes my SolidWorks. Right, there we are. In SolidWorks, that's the file. It was originally a SolidWorks CAD file. It's just being managed in the system in the 3DEXPERIENCE platform at the moment. And you can see on the right hand side, I actually have 3DEXPERIENCE platform inside SolidWorks. So users can work directly from SolidWorks without going into the platform, since it's already actually in there. Here I can set things like maturity states, so you can see in work, frozen, released, or obsolete, for example. Simply a click of a button. I can also add new revisions. I can branch off from a revision. So it's a good way to do configurations, for example. Collaboration tool, so I can lock this. Obviously, if I've got the item open, I want to lock it so nobody else can see it. And then, of course, I can see all my PLM information directly in the SolidWorks interface. I can also go and generate some derived output, so things like step files. I can print it out, and I can also go and assign the enterprise item number, which is essentially a part number or serial number. And I can go and see what this model is linked to. So what is using it and what else downstream is linked to this particular CAD model. If there was a drawing, for example, you would see that here. You can see the assembly that it's part of on the left-hand side. And of course, since this is the platform in SolidWorks, you can go and do things like search for another item. So I'm going to go and grab the gearbox. There's everything that's got gearbox in the name. And I simply take the one that I want and drag and drop it in. Close my search. Rebuild the model since something changed, and there we go. Now all the information linked to that model comes up in my session, shows me the status, is everything saved, what's been locked, what has changed, all the other metadata around description and so on. So there you can see these items are unlocked. It's only the last item which is locked, and it's locked by me. If it was locked by someone else, it would tell you. You'd see that over the tooltip, it would tell you it's locked by somebody else. And this is the platform directly in SolidWorks. So you can see I can access all my other roles and all the apps linked to those roles directly from here. And all my notifications will also show up in SolidWorks directly too. So that was just a quick overview of what the 3D Experience platform looks and feels like. Let's talk about the benefits of linking SolidWorks to the 3D Experience platform. I would say SolidWorks, but really it could be any other CAD tool, such as Inventor or Creo, for example. Your CAD data is available enterprise-wide without the need for more CAD licenses. Users downstream from the engineering and design department, so for example manufacturing or maybe even the stores department, can access the model and visually validate that, for example, for stores, the item that is coming into stores is actually the item that was procured or manufactured. Data is accessible from anywhere, anytime, on any device, since the platform is a browser-based tool. You have full control of your CAD and other business data, so there's no more lost or misplaced files or overwritten files, which is often the case in a CAD environment, where the last person to save is the one whose work is maintained and everybody else loses their work. Revision control and change management is built in, and there's a full history for auditing purposes in the background. So think of quality audit or a compliancy audit from a big supplier, for example, in aerospace and defense. Because of the collaborative nature of the platform, you break the interdepartmental silos and reduce the internal inertia to make the whole team and thus the company more effective and efficient. And of course, putting your CAD data into 3D Experience platform with all of the other functionality that it offers to you is a good step to a virtual twin.